Paramyxovirus is a serious and potentially deadly disease that can strike fear into the heart of pigeon fanciers. In this video, we will discuss its history, symptoms, and treatment. Pigeon paramyxovirus serotype 1, often shortened to PPMV1, or simply PMV, is a viral disease that primarily affects pigeons and doves, though on occasion it has spread to other species. Pigeon paramyxovirus is a member of the well-known Newcastle disease complex, a family of diseases that cause serious problems for poultry producers worldwide. Paramyxoviruses that target various species are known throughout the world. The virus that infects pigeons is thought to have first developed in the Middle East, most likely Iraq, in the late 1970s. It is thought that the first infected pigeon may have been exposed to a form of Newcastle disease by a member of another species, which mutated into a pigeon infectious strain. The virus is highly contagious, and from Iraq, it spread quickly, both naturally and aided by humans transporting pigeons for races and exhibition events. By the early 1980s, pigeon paramyxovirus had reached both North Africa and Eastern Europe, where it spread like wildfire westward into Europe and eastward into Asia. During the 1990s, disease outbreaks occurred in the Americas also. Australia's geographic isolation helped shield it from paramyxovirus. The nation had had Newcastle disease scares in the past, but it wasn't until 2011 that the pigeon infectious strain reached the country. The source of the outbreak was never confirmed, but illegally smuggled pigeons or eggs are a likely culprit. Pigeon paramyxovirus serotype 1 is now considered endemic almost worldwide. As a highly contagious disease, pigeon paramyxovirus can be spread through a variety of vectors. The virus is primarily spread between domestic pigeons through infected droppings, vomit, and other bodily fluids. Transmission from wild birds is also possible, and because of this, fanciers are encouraged to not feed wild birds near their lofts. Virus material is also very stable in the environment, and can survive for weeks outside of the body. Because of this, it should be noted that this infection can be spread from loft to loft by contaminated droppings on a fancier's boots or clothing. Shoes should be washed and clothing changed before tending to your pigeons after visiting another loft. The disease has quite a long incubation period once infection occurs. Symptoms could begin to appear anywhere between a few days to 6 weeks later. Symptoms of the infection often begin with noticeable lethargy, which develops into vomiting, watery droppings or diarrhea, and respiratory illness. Other pigeons in the loft are quickly infected by consuming the diseased vomit and droppings during this stage. Neurological symptoms such as uncontrolled spinning, a twisting of the neck, gazing skyward, a general loss of coordination, and partial paralysis a characteristic of a PMV outbreak. Of course, if a paramyxovirus infection is suspected, contact with a veterinarian should be made to confirm the diagnosis. In many places, it is compulsory to report the diagnosis of any form of Newcastle disease, such as pigeon paramyxovirus, to governmental authorities. Symptoms may occasionally be confused with a salmonella outbreak. A qualified avian vet can make an accurate diagnosis. This is a deadly disease. When paramyxovirus infects the loft or community of pigeons, a mortality rate of 10 to 100% is common. Death is more common in younger birds, with older pigeons often having a higher rate of survival. Pigeons who do recover will continue to act as disease carriers for many months, and may infect other healthy birds. Recovered pigeons may also have their flying or racing ability detrimentally affected for life. Because of the highly contagious and deadly nature of this virus, vaccination is recommended and is actually made compulsory by many racing and exhibition clubs, as well as governmental and regulatory authorities. There is no cure or antidote for this virus. Death is common, though the survival rate of paramyxovirus-infected individuals may be boosted by supportive care during the disease phase. Actions such as hand feeding, as well as the application of probiotics and electrolytes, may be effective. As no cure for paramyxovirus exists, fanciers must take steps to prevent infections from ever occurring. Biosecurity measures can be helpful, but as PMV has long incubation and carry periods, and the disease-causing material can survive for weeks outside of the bird's body, vaccination is likely the only viable method of control. A number of commercial vaccines are produced by various pharmaceutical companies worldwide, and fanciers should seek advice from their local veterinary professional when choosing a vaccine. If a yearly booster shot is recommended, it is important to ensure this takes place. Otherwise, immunity levels may drop, putting the bird at risk of infection. Though primarily a disease of domestic pigeons and other closely related species, PMV1 occasionally infects other species, including very rarely humans. Pigeon paramyxovirus in humans is very rare, and when it does occur, causes only mild, flu-like symptoms. A visit to a doctor is recommended, however, an infection typically isn't a major cause for concern in humans. Paramyxovirus is a highly contagious disease that can cause great losses and impact surviving pigeons' racing abilities. This disease is endemic in wild and domestic pigeons worldwide, but is easily prevented by enacting common sense biosecurity measures and adequate vaccination. If you found this video helpful, please press like and consider subscribing for more videos like this one.